Thanks for coming then.
Yeah, no worries.
Yeah, I just wanted to let you know, I was going to ask you some questions about your practice and about what you're about.
Yeah.
I just want to see what you've got going on, really.
Yeah, no, of course, far away, mate.
So maybe we'll start with what's your. Yeah, don't worry about that. So what's your. What are you working on at the moment?
Just, you know, a bit of everything at the moment. I was down with. I was working with Jürgen a little bit last week. We've got a new photo project going on. It's really lovely. It's like, you know, got some really beautiful things. Really like playing off each other's strengths. You know, like I'm bringing in a lot of my my musical influence, and he's, you know, talking about what his photography is. So, you know.
Are you often involved in collaborations with quite, you know, highbrow?
Yeah, I mean, they find me. They seek me out. It's quite amazing, really. You know, the. Just, you know, coming to me, you know, just here from West London. But,
let's talk about
that. Yeah, so, I mean, like the name, I'm from Richmond. Grew up in my parents' place, just, you know, not too far off, like, Kew Gardens kind of area. But, it was a fun upbringing, you know, a lot of really interesting people around that part.
Well,
yeah, no. Like, I think that's the thing about London. It's so diverse. You know, I'm from everywhere, and at once, you know, I identify with Richmond because that's how I feel strong in it, and you know, my specific upbringing. But you know, like, I think it's unfair to put labels on people of like, you know, but anyway.
Yeah, where did you study?
I didn't have a formal education. I went to school. I didn't like school at all. I really hated it. But I went out of school quite young because I never turned up. I'd only go in like they have chips at the canteen or something like that. But I hated. The whole structure of it. I found it really like negative for my kind of way of expressing myself. So, you know, I had to find a different route. And a big part of that for me was, you know, spending time in the studio. And that's the music studio and the art studio and you know, the fashion studio. All in one go, you know, it was really important for me to just express myself across a multitude of different kind of disciplines.
For me,
music has always been my first love. I loved music because it was just, there was something about it that you know, it captivated me. You know, I was listening to music before I could read. Like, I didn't get into painting and stuff until I was much, much older. But music had been like the thing that was with me the whole time. I started a label when I was really young. And I had to, you know, had to see that through. I didn't want to get distracted by the other things, like painting had always been a big part for me. But like, I just found it was sometimes getting aware of, you know, what I wanted to do with my music. So I couldn't sacrifice that. It was too important. But it's only since kind of I've matured now, you know, like I'm 20 years old, like I know the world. No, I've got like a, you know, much world weary kind of experience. I know what I'm doing and what story I have to tell. So I think, you know, being like that, I now can say that I have this appreciation for painting and the fashion and these things, you know.
Who would you say is kind of helped you out the most in the journey?
Just when I was younger, you know, I surrounded myself with good people. Not people that, you know, most people would approve of, I suppose. But that's you know, my own story, my own journey. I need to be, you know, I mean, a part of my name, the enrichment for this is that, you know, I find it's really important to keep to that identity because that's where the people were from that kind of influenced my journey. So I represent all of them.
All of Britain.
Yeah, that's how I feel. It is. I'm like the mouthpiece for a location, but a generation as well.
And what do you think the voice of Richmond wants to say?
I think it's about individuality. It's about things. It's the same in all of them, really. But Richmond is a promise with. Next question, let's go. Come on.
You don't want to continue?
No.
It seems such an important part of you. Give me a really interesting question.
No, it is important. It is important. Can you not be like that with me? I'm very busy. I'm taking this time out to talk to you right now. Can we just talk about stuff that I'm asking?
Let's move on.
Okay, yeah.
Can someone get a drink? What do you want?
Yeah. Water, sparkling.
Sparkling. Room warm? Mm-hmm. Room temperature?
No. How long? Right.
Anyway, so, what's your next project?
I've been thinking about it, and I've got this exhibition coming up. It's going to be quite a big one. It's in Mayfair. Do you know the Roncini Gallery? They've recommended to tell us at 15, because I met the owner and he fell in love with my work straight away. I'm working on that. But also I have a new collection that I'm releasing, and it actually ties into this exhibition I'm doing, because it's. I like to see that there's a lot of passover between my disciplines, like I've said. When I talk about making art and then making clothing and making music, like they all influence each other. And sometimes the references can be exactly the same thing. And so I'm making my art, and then that tells me, sometimes quite directly, sometimes I'll do a painting or collage. And like those photos, I'd be like, I need to create like a universality for it. Because sometimes just being on the wall somewhere is like not enough. So I've got to make some kind of like clothing out of it, design, but like.
Do you think of yourself as a brand?
I think a brand is a. I don't want you to call me brand, but I don't.
Why don't you call me brand?
I mean, this isn't getting reported.
No, this is not.
Okay, brand makes me sound dirty. I'm just doing my own thing. I'm like, it's enterprise, but it's like, it's not a bad thing.
Some of your friends are recently on H&M t-shirt.
Yeah, but that's like creativity again. It's like it's collaboration between the images. But also I need to. No. You see, because I've got to make it universal. As I was saying, I have my own stuff, but sometimes there are a lot of people respect me, okay, and a lot of people want to be, they want to buy into my vision, and so when I've got a thing that I want to say, like an artwork or something like that, then I've got to make that work, and it's got to reach lots of people. And so in order for it to reach people, sometimes people can't afford to buy stuff that I make. So it's like H&M, now they can afford it. No, I mean it was very lucrative for everyone involved. It was like, it meant that like young people could really like embrace what I was about, you know?
And what is Richmond about, other than the area?
Like, me, it's about, like, you know, I've got a story to tell.
And where does that story start from?
It centres me growing up being this creative presence, and like, you know, I had to deal with, like, you know, people don't respect me in the way that they should sometimes because I didn't go to university. And it's like, and because of that, you know, I have to deal with all the stigma about, you know, like, oh, he's, whatever, doesn't know what he's talking about. He thinks, like, you know, he's better than everyone else because he's working with, and, you know, in some ways, yeah, maybe they're right, maybe I am. Sometimes, you know, I've worked hard for stuff because I didn't have this like formal education. I didn't need it. I didn't need it because I already had it, you know? Yeah, where's that water? Can we talk more about the collection or the new artwork, please?
Okay, great, yeah. So, with the new work that you've made, what's it called?
It's a working title at the moment. It's Iconography Unveiled.
Iconography Unveiled. What artists would you say have inspired this piece?
You know, like, I mean, like, artists are, you know, such a broad term, you know, like, the way I see artists is like, you know, you can do anything, you can be an artist. But might be that's a really strong way of seeing it because, you know, I don't like this kind of like pigeonholing someone being like, oh yeah, you're an artist because you paint, or you're an artist because you make sculptures. Like, you can be an artist and you can do whatever you want. Yeah.
It's really interesting. So, you've been scientific quotes to say that you think you're the new Bastion.
Well, I mean,
better than Basquiat.
No. You see, I didn't say that. My publicist said that, and I had a word with him afterwards, and I said, I don't care what you think. I don't think I should be comparing myself to, you know. I was like, you can say that, but like that doesn't come from me because it's like, yeah, maybe I am, you know, a fresh face on the art world. Maybe, you know, I have, you know. Possibly, like, culturally the same significance as someone like that. But you know, that's not something that I say because that wouldn't be right for me to say that.
And then who do you admire in art at the moment?
I don't think we should have, you know, icons. You know, obviously, you know, I adore Francis Bacon. But now, you know, that's the people that I work with. I'm thinking about photography, I think about the last photographer I worked with, you know, which was, when I was working with the collection.
And I wonder if you can tell us a little bit about the conflict you and Paul
had. He called me out something, which, you know, I don't want to continue the beef. I think, you know, like, there's a big part of, like, you know, young people like to kind of, they really get into these, like, you know, celebrity fights and that. But no, he was very rude about kind of where he didn't think I earned what I did, and you know, we had a very similar trajectory in terms of, you know, like, we collaborated with a lot of people, we crossed platforms, but. He felt that it was something that wasn't my input and not. I think that's a disgusting thing to say because I've earned everything I've done. I have from the ground up.
Brands.
Well, you know, I mean, at this point I'm trying to figure out who I'm going to work with, at least on something, but maybe something Italian, you know, like, something like, I feel like Gucci is always a good place to go, you know, they have such a strong vision, that I'm like, you know, I respect that, because I have a strong vision, and maybe that's where we need to go together. To create something that can really be appreciated by the world.
It'd be great.
Yeah.